believe it's a morning song. We can sing this in the afternoon also. Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Welcome.
I believe it's a morning song. We can sing this in the afternoon also. But we are going to sing number 34 this morning with the song of joy and gladness. I hope those of you who have not yet awakened, this song may ring in your ears and may get you out of bed. Amen. And those of you who are awakened, you can be revitalized and energized with the song of joy and gladness. Sing along with us.
With the song of joy and gladness, we'll bring you nobleness, bliss, banish every thought of sadness, for in thought highest prayers. Sing to him whose care has brought us once again. Song
We ought to praise Him. We ought to glorify Him. We ought to worship Him. Good morning to you. Amen.
Sun to rule the day, the moon shines full and is gone.
tread, all is upon the skies. There's not a plant or flower below
but makes thy glories
known, and clouds arise and tempests flow by wonderful, wonderful. That should set you on your way this morning as you prepare for work, as you prepare for school, as you get the children ready, as you are already on the train, on the bus, wherever you may be. My friends, that should give you some hope. I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise. And if God made a mountain rise, he can fix issues in your life this morning.
Yes, thank you.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
shore. I will meet you.
I will
meet you on that beautiful shore.
All right, this morning it's one of our favorites. Matter of fact, it's our favorite because it's your favorite. I would say it's impact favorite. Number 75, the wonder of it all. You know, I'm such a sinner. Yes, yes, yes. I'm a sinner. All have sinned and come short. Like Paul, he says he was a chief of sinners. And it's a wonder that he loves me, a sinner like me, the things that I've done, and he has forgiven me. He has cleansed me from my unrighteousness. There is the wonder of sunset at evening. Let's sing the song. Join us.
Set at evening, a wondrous sunrise I see. By the wonder of wonders that thrills my soul is the
tears to your eyes just to think that Jesus can love a sinner, a liar, a cheat, an alcoholic, a prostitute, a terrible tempered person with bad attitude like me, and he forgives me. He says if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive you all your sins and to cleanse you, cleanse us, cleanse me from all my unrighteousness. What a wonderful God we serve. What a loving God. Amen. I've chosen to serve him this morning. How about you?
Good morning. Good morning to all of you. Thank you for joining us again this morning. What a joy and what a pleasure to come together with God's people to worship. Wow. Well, we've had a long theme, We have a new theme today, and our theme is entitled The Great Controversy and the Struggle for Supremacy. You got to be here for our devotional, The Great Controversy and the Struggle for Supremacy. So, you got to be here so that we go through this experience of the great controversy and the supremacy and the struggle for supremacy together. You won't want to miss it. And so we encourage you to share with friends, share with family members, because that's where the world is today. The world is engaged in a controversy. The world is engaged in a struggle. It's the cosmic conflict, and they are jockeying for supremacy. What's happening there in Israel, and what's happening there with Iran sending all of those drones and ballistic missiles over to Israel, all have to do with this great controversy, this cosmic conflict, this struggle and battle for supremacy. And everybody is jockeying. Everybody is taking out their claim that they are supreme more than the other, that their bombs are more powerful. They have more ballistic missile and weapons of mass destruction in their arsenal. Russia is boasting of its stash of nuclear weapons over America. You know, it claims that it got a few more than America would have, and America is boasting that it has the fastest in this. The great controversy and the struggle for supremacy. Even us human beings are also positioning ourselves as the supreme race, the supreme mind. Who is more powerful? Who is more supreme? Who is Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the most supreme one of all? So we are in for a little experience as we travel through this devotional together. Sister Janet Perkins and Angela, Florent, Anthony George, Crawford, and so we are thankful you are here, Tessa Noel. It's good seeing you. I think I missed you for a few days. Maybe it's just my eyes, but I think I missed you. All right. Devery. It's good seeing you. Delia Hill, I think I missed you for a few days too. Sister Hill, and so it's good seeing you all. Lady J and Karen Francis, Sister McLean, Norma McLean, Sister Charles, Louis, Tia Charles, and we're going to have some fun together, Sister Gart, on the great controversy, all right, and the struggle for supremacy in our devotional. Sister Novlet and Daly, good morning to you. It's always good seeing you. You've been with us from the beginning of time, I remembered. Sister Daly, always good seeing you. Right, Shamin Bihari, it's good seeing you. A wonder all that to think Jesus loves me. Yes, he loves me. He loves you. All right, very good. We have Cooper F. Faithful. I know you guys are very faithful. We got Minister Don Baxter. If we never meet on this side, I will meet you on the beautiful side of heaven. Praise the Lord, Minister Baxter. She is a very, very active minister in the community. We are happy to have her here. Are we going to pray? And we are going to move into our devotional. These days I have all early activities. So this is a devotional. So I'm planning. It's a struggle for me because there is so much to talk about. But I'm planning not to keep you too long. Father in heaven, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are so thankful again that you have seen it fit to be with us this morning. You have seen it fit to keep the breath in our nostrils for one more day. Many others cannot testify to that because they have fallen asleep. And we pray that those who have fallen asleep in you. Even this morning, there may be impact followers, impact family members who are experiencing the death of loved ones. And we pray this morning that you may be with those grieving the loss of loved ones. We pray that you may comfort every heart this morning. It's not an easy thing. Losing loved ones. Oh, my mother, she's 87. She's still kicking. She's still doing well. And when I visit her, oh, how my heart to see when I remembered her as a boy and to see how she is moving towards the sunset of her life. Even my heart starts aching and breaking. Comfort those whose hearts are aching and breaking and saddened and are in pain. But we pray that you may speak to us this morning and give us some hope. Give us some hope. Emerge as the one most supreme. Emerge as the one who is in control of the affairs of mankind. Emerge as our champion this morning, even as we make our way to work, as we prepare the children for school, and as we prepare for our activities, as we stand at the kitchen sink, and as we are moving back and forth from the bathroom to the bedroom and the living room, and running for the transit and transportation, be with us. We thank you, O God, for being the champion of our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. My friends, it's been years we've been at this, many years. And I am glad that God has afforded us the energy to continue with this global devotional. And I want to thank you for your encouragement and for hanging there with us. Thank you so much. The great controversy and the struggle for supremacy. My friends, like I said at the beginning, everybody's jockeying for some position on the world stage, especially these nations and these nations who emerged as supreme over our nations, and even the rogue nations are jockeying and positioning themselves for supremacy. But my friends, I want to leave the nation and come down to those that God created in his image and his likeness. Ah, yes, even the baby born. When we listen to the cry of the baby, we see the baby is also sticking out its claim as, I am the one in need here. I am the one who is jockeying for position and jockeying for supremacy here. And the baby will let out a bawl, letting the mother know, I am the one who needs attention. And it seems like everybody is jockeying for attention. And we go back to the beginning of time when God created the heavens and the earth. And even before that, when he created the angels who stood in his presence, we see there is an arch enemy. There is a character in the plot of creation, jockeying for supremacy, jockeying for control. And so thus we'll be talking about the great controversy and the struggle for supremacy. And so those of you who understand the doctrines of the Bible, the great controversy is one of the doctrines, I would say one of the fundamental beliefs, or should be one of the fundamental beliefs of every church. The great controversy, because this belief, this doctrine started, my friends, with a beautiful angel. And so this fundamental belief of the church is dubbed as the cosmic conflict between God and Satan. That's what we are experiencing in our world today. The cosmic conflict between God and Satan, between good and evil, between right and wrong, between life and death. That's what you are experiencing on a daily basis. Every time you wake up in the morning, every time you turn on the TV and you see and you hear the people announcing, broadcasting the news, telling of the breaking news, every time you hear that the conflict between Israel and Gaza, between Iran and Israel, between America and Russia, we are listening to this great controversy. We are involved at the center of this conflict that began in heaven. It's this cosmic conflict between God and Satan. Every time your knees are aching you, my friends, you are you are in the midst of this great controversy, this conflict, this supremacy, this struggle for supremacy. My friends, every time you hear of a shooting and a killing, my friends, this is the conflict between good and evil. Whenever we see an ex-president, my friends, doing the things that he's doing and causing insurrection against his own government, you are in the midst of the struggle and the experience between right and wrong. When men and women, my friends, are taking up weapons in conflict against each other. We are involved in the struggle between life and death. My friends, we are involved in this thing. We are part and parcel of all of the things that are happening. My friends, every time your rent goes up, you are involved in this great controversy. Every time you get into an accident on the street, you are in the midst of it. This is the struggle. This is the war. This is the battle. This is the conflict that you are involved in on a daily basis. It's a struggle for supremacy. God wants to save you, and the devil wants you to be lost. God wants to protect you, and the devil wants you to be like an animal of prey. You see, it's open warfare on you. The devil isolates you for the punks. He isolates you. And that's the reason, my friends, as a member of God's church, as a follower of Christ, the Bible says, do not forsake the assembly of yourself together. The reason being, because when the devil isolates you, you can get discouraged. You can feel lonely, you see. And then you feel pity for yourself. And then you want to give up. I want to die. I want to go to heaven. Uh-huh. You know. And many people, when they are lonely, the devil speaks to their minds. And they want to commit suicide. It's all part of this great conflict, this great controversy between good and evil. So what is this great controversy, my friends? Well, the most captivating stories have a clear hero and a villain. A clear hero and a villain. My friends, I am here to tell you this morning, Sister Avril Lewin. Yes, and Sister Nadine Lubin, although there is a villain, I'm going to start with a villain first. Glory, hallelujah. Although God has an arch enemy that is responsible for all of these turmoil and issues taking place, I would have you to know this morning, give you a word of hope. With every villain, there is a hero. You ought to start rejoicing on this. This is the word of hope I want to give you this morning. My friends, with every crash, with every vehicular crash, with every disabled vehicle by the side of the street, my friends, there is someone who is a fixer. There is someone who can put it together. There is a hero in all of this. Glory, hallelujah, Tamoy Rudock Carter. Listening keenly, Pastor. Glory, Sister Norma McLean, Linville Archer. Yes, B. Smill, she has gotten it. Ah, yes, she resounded with glory, hallelujah, because there is a hero. You got a hero. When you've heard the story of when the outlaw, glory, hallelujah, when the outlaw comes to town and he challenges the hero, he challenges, my friends, that supreme leader. When the outlaw comes to town and he challenges the sheriff, and you know, the little boy was reading the book, and he had not yet read the end of the book, and he saw his hero getting beat up. He saw his hero being tossed to the ground. He saw his hero being kicked and slapped. He saw his hero, my friends, being punched and laughed at. And the little boy was angry that his hero was getting and being taken advantage of. But glory, hallelujah, the little boy couldn't take it anymore. And the little boy said, no, 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 something must be the matter. Something must be wrong here. He seems like the villain is unleashing all of these evil and all of these sorrow and all of these pain and heartache upon the human family. And the little boy went and he read the end of the book, and he saw that his hero, my friends, had the upper hand. Finally. Glory, hallelujah. And so I am here to tell you this morning, yes, you are going to work. I want to give you hope on your way to work. You are on the job. Although this whole great controversy is captivating, stories upon stories, and although, my friends, we see the villain at work on a daily basis, accidents on the road, but glory, hallelujah, I would have you to know today there is a hero. And that hero, my friends, got your back today. That hero is your friend. That hero is your shield. That hero is your buckler, my friends. Someone fights for good and the other fights for evil. And so we see it in the movies. We see the villain and we see the heroes. We see it, my friends. And the good thing about movies, for some strange reason, the movie, most movie, 99% of movie always ends up with the hero having the upper hand. And that's how it will end up. The great controversy will end up with the hero having the upper hand. I am here to encourage you this morning not to lose heart. Glory, hallelujah. Keep hope alive because there is hope. The hero always has the upper hand, regardless of what the villain does, regardless of what the antagonist does. There is a protagonist. Ah, yes, we talk about script today. We talk about movies. There is a protagonist, but this is not a movie. This is real. This is authentic. Someone fights for you. I hope somebody understands what I'm saying. Someone fights for you, Donald Roberts. Someone, Sister Janet Chambers, fights for you. And he is your hero this morning. I want you to go to work in your mind, hearing the resounding theme that someone is your hero. And there is someone who fights for you this morning. It doesn't matter what happens on the job today. There is someone who is your hero. Your boss may not be your hero. And yes, there is hope in King Jesus because King Jesus is your hero. Glory, hallelujah. Pain is not, my friends, will not have the upper hand on you. Sorrow will not have the upper hand. Weeping, my friends, will not have the upper hand. It may endure for a night, but your hero shows up in the morning to rescue you. And when that hero shows up, he comes with joy. That hero comes with happiness. That hero comes with gladness. That hero, my friends, brings with him healing. Somebody say, glory, hallelujah. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy, Margaret Raymond, comes in the morning. Glory, hallelujah. It's easy to look at this messed up world and believe that clearly defined battles between good and evil only happens in stories. But my friends, no. I will not trivialize what you are going through. It's not a story. It's a reality. The pain that you suffer on a daily basis, my friends, shows that you are involved in this great controversy. We live in a messed up world. It's not a story what you are going through. It's not some fabrication of what you are going through. But your hero knows this. Your hero sees what you are going through. Your hero sees that you are going to cough up that money to pay the taxes. Your hero sees that you may not too sure where your next rent is coming from. This is not just a story. This is a messed up world. This is not a world of make-believe. This is real. But glory, hallelujah, you got to keep your eyes on your hero, because your hero got plans for your happiness. Your hero got plans, my friends, for your success. He does. Matter of fact, he says, I have plans for you. Plans to give you a good future. Starting today, my friends, today is a new day for you, because your hero says he got plans for you, not plans to do you harm. If any harms come to you today, it's not your hero. It's the villain. It's the arch enemy who tried to jab you, and he may have gotten a jab, because this is a war. This is a conflict. And every now and then, my friends, every now and then, we pull away from the hero. Every now and then, we want to be on our own. Every now and then, we want to do our thing, like Adam and Eve. Every now and then, my friends, we want to listen to the villain. And the villain is not there for our good. The villain is there for our harm. Matter of fact, the Bible says, the devil comes. That's the villain. He comes to steal your joy. He comes to kill, but the Lord comes, glory, somebody start rejoicing. But Jesus comes that you may have life. Oh, I just like it. I just love it. But your hero comes, Sister God. My hero sees what I can't see. I like that. I like that. He knows what I don't know. I like that, Sister God. You're helping me this morning. Yes. His name is given. Let me see. A name above all names. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Emmanuel, God with us. I like it. I like when you guys help me this morning. Because guess what? You see where I am going. This theme is going to be excited. So those who are not here, because I may have ran the other theme too long, so they may have the planning, my friends. But this is where it is. This is what life is all about, is the struggle, until our hero decides to show up and put a total end to it. But in the midst of it, my friends, we are involved, but guess what? When Jesus came, although he met pain here when he came, although he met loneliness, although when he came, my friends, he came in a world of sadness. The Bible says he came under the law where we were, you see, struggling, wallowing in our sins. There is hope. That's the good news. There is hope in the midst of hopelessness. And so Jesus says, the devil came. Yes, he came too. Jesus said, I saw him as lightning falling from heaven. And he came to this earth. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth. Woe unto them. It's all part of the great controversy. Woe! Your enemy has come down. The arch enemy, the devil, has come down unto you, having great wrath. This arch enemy, this villain, this antagonist, he is angry. He is angry. So don't think it a strange thing when you go to the job and see people quarreling. You go on the train and you see some guy walking there brandishing stuff. You see people fighting and folks, you know, pushing others off the platform on the subway and so forth. It's all the devil. It's part of the great controversy. He came to bring pain, but Jesus came to give life, my friends, but not just life, even in the here. Even today, you can still enjoy abundant life, even today. as you jump on the train, as you go to work, you can still enjoy abundant life in the midst of chaos. So Pastor John, amen, amen, amen. Here, Sister Nilfer Thomas is engaged in this great controversy, this great conflict, this fight. By even the sound of a prayer, Pastor, please help me pray for a job that I don't have to be asked to work on God's Sabbath. Ah, yes, yes, yes. That was what happened to me at my last job about a month ago. I lost it because I didn't do it. Call me. We can write you a letter. You should have called me first. All right, the law is on your side. The law is on your side. I don't know where you are, Sister Nilfer Thomas, but please get in contact with me. I hadn't seen you for a few weeks. I looked on the screen, and I didn't. But call me, please. I mean that. All right, and let's talk about it, and let's see how we can help you. All right. We can, you shouldn't have to lose. Well, it depends on where you are. Here in America, in New York, we can write letters. The law is on your side, all right? The law is on your side. Father, you hear your daughter. She wants to honor you. She needs a job where she does not have to work on the Sabbath. And so I pray even now that you may have mercy and to champion her issue, because we have declared you. We don't have to declare you. You are our hero, and your daughter needs her hero to stand up for her even now in the midst of this great controversy, in the midst of this great conflict, in the midst of the struggle for supremacy. The boss thinks he is supreme over your daughter, but he's not. You are her hero. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray. Ah, yes, hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. My friends, so my friends, you have a hero this morning. That's how I want you to leave this morning. It's going to be a theme. We're going to be talking about the great controversy. That's what waking up every morning is all about, Sister Imogen Hutchinson. It's about this great controversy we are involved in. In Jesus' name, amen. You guys are too beautiful. Yes, Shirley Bart. So again, as I was saying, it's easy to look at this messed up world and believe that clearly defined battles between good and evil only happens in stories. No, matter of fact, that's what the movies are made of. The movies are made of reality. They just snatch the theme of the creation of this world. And they put it in movie form. You know, Superman is about this good and evil motif. You see, but we have our Superman. We have our hero, you see, who also came down upon this planet. And who took our place. He died in our stead. My friends, he is victorious. This arch enemy is defeated. He is a liar. We read the end of the book and we see his defeat. We see his demise. So my friends, I will never trivial what every one of you, everyone is experiencing. Ah, everyone. Yes, 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 yes. So, but still, yes, it's called religious liberty. So you know what I'm talking about. So please. But you can still give me a call. Let's talk about it, all right? Let's talk about it. And so, my friends, everything here is so mixed up. Everything here is so messed up. That's how the arch enemy wants it. Ah, yes, but our hero, my friends, he appeared to be imperfect when he came down on this earth because he died. He died on the cross of Calvary. My friends, but don't miss the point. That hero died. He appeared to be imperfect. But death couldn't keep him in the grave. Death couldn't keep him down. Your hero, my friends, is victorious. And that villain thought he had the upper hand on our hero. But my friends, that hero died on the cross of Calvary. And that Friday evening, we just finished Easter. That hero was placed in the grave. Glory, hallelujah. And he stayed, he slept in the grave on that Sabbath day, and he arose early Sunday morning, victorious. So I would have you to know, although your hero got thrown to the ground, although your hero endured the kicks and the punches and the spitting and the slapping, although your hero, my friends, endure the cruel bruising of his skull with a crown of thorns pressed down into his innocent head, my friends, and although our hero endured the nails being pierced and pounded through his hands and his feet, my friends, and although we experience the blood and water gushing out of our hero, and although our hero bowed his head and gave up the ghost and declared, "It is finished," my friends, glory, hallelujah, early Sunday morning, our hero emerged as supreme. Our hero emerge, my friends, as conqueror. So I would have you to know today, it doesn't matter what you are experiencing, what you are going through, your hero is victorious. Your hero is triumphant. Your hero is a conqueror. He can conquer your enemies. And I would have you to know, because you have accepted your hero as your savior, as your friend, as your redeemer, as your fighter. The Bible says you are more than conqueror. You are more than a conqueror through the efforts and through the merits and through the acts and the action and through the sacrifice of your hero. You are more than a conqueror this morning. You can conquer that sickness. You can conquer that pain this morning. You can conquer, my friends, that conflict between you and your boss and your job this morning. Because your hero, my friends, is a conqueror. And you are more than a conqueror as a result of your hero. It's not uncommon to see people do horrible things, my friends, to God's people. But I would have you to know that you are a conqueror. It doesn't matter what the devil throws at you. Once you run to your hero, hide behind his back, he got your back. Hide behind him, he got your back. He says, "I am your shield and I am your buckler." Jesus, your hero, your conqueror, is able to shield you today. Yes, I'm going to go about my business today. I'm going to climb on the train today. I am. I'm going to do what I need to do today because my hero is also my conqueror. He is my shield. He is my buckler. And yes, nothing could happen to me today. Nothing can happen to me today that God, that my hero, my conqueror, and I cannot handle. Nothing. Nothing can happen to you today that you and your hero cannot handle. Nothing, Petal Campbell. Nothing can happen that you and Jesus cannot handle. With you and Jesus, with you connected to the power and the strength of your hero, guess what? With you today connected to the vine, connected to the source of power, with you, there is nothing you cannot do. You are more than a conqueror. Nothing can happen to you today that you and your hero cannot handle. You have become supreme over the arch enemy. In Jesus' name. We're going to close right here, Pat Leslie. We're going to be riding this theme not until the end of the year, because I have many to talk about. At the end of the conflict, Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. I like this. At the end of the conflict, Jesus is still supreme. The great controversy and the struggle for supremacy. The arch enemy never has the upper hand. There is nothing too hard for the Lord to do for us. I believe that. And I love that also at the end of the conflict, Jesus is Lord. At the end, Jennifer Clark, at the end of the day, let's contemporalize it. Let's contextualize it. Let's bring it to where you are. You're going to work. You're preparing the children for work. My friends, you're preparing breakfast and all of those things. I would say at the end of the day, when the day has ended, Sister Dawson, Jesus is still king. Jesus is still conqueror. Jesus is still your fighter. He is still your hero. At the end of the day, the devil is still a loser and Jesus is the winner. As the children sing, he is a winner man, a winner man, a winner man, a winner man. He is the winner man and the devil is the loser man. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Yes, Sister Dawson, I got your letter. I got your letter. It came safely. In Jesus' name. Well, my friends, I just want to thank you again for joining us. So this is a taste of what we will be dealing with. This is a taste. I will bring some powerful scripture. This was just the introduction for today. So my appeal to you is trust in your hero. My appeal to you is believe in your hero. My appeal to you today is to draw nigh unto your hero, and he will draw nigh to you. When the enemy comes to conquer you, you see, your enemy is like a roaring lion. He wants to isolate you from the team. He wants to isolate you from those who care about you. He wants to isolate you and keep you home, sad and lonely and depressed and thinking suicide. But my friends, my appeal to you is to stay near to Jesus. Stay close to your hero. Draw nigh unto God, and he will draw nigh unto you. Resist the antagonist. Resist that villain, and he will flee in Jesus' name. He will flee from you. He's a coward. He's a coward. He can only conquer when he isolates you. He can only pounce on you when no one else and when your hero is not, or you are not close to your hero. And so resist him by being close to your hero, and he will flee. The devil is a liar. He is a loser man. And so see the devil flee from you today. All you need to do is to invoke the name of your hero, Jesus. Jesus. Invoke the name of your hero, and the devil will flee from you. Father in heaven, in the mighty name of Jesus, we want to thank you this morning for waking us up this morning. Our hero, keeping the breath in our nostrils. The evil one has already started on your people. He is a liar. He is a loser. You are the winner man. You are our Lord. You are our protector. You are our creator. You are our provider, our sustainer. You are our redeemer and soon coming King. We thank you this morning for encouraging our hearts that you are the winner, man. You are our hero. You are our conqueror. You are our fighter. And yes, we, because of you, are more than conquerors. Be with your people. You have seen all of the prayers. You have seen all of your prayers. You have seen all of the prayers on the screen. Sister McLean, you know, she's asking for prayer. You know, she's traveling to New York tomorrow. Traveling to New York. And I hope I see that lady of yours when she comes to New York. So give her safe traveling mercies. My niece is also traveling to New York tomorrow from Trinidad and Tobago. Traveling. I pray for safe traveling mercies for her tomorrow. I pray this morning for those suffering the loss of loved ones. I pray for Tamoy Rudak Carter, for her daughter Brianna. I know not the issue, but you know. You know. You know the issue. So we pray that you may champion her cause as her hero this morning. And we pray that her daughter Brianna may have a testimony, may testify of the power of prayer and of the role of her hero in her life. Pray for Sister Avis Rattray this morning. I pray for Eagle Wings and pray this morning for Sister Selma Lawrence. I pray for her and her family. I pray for Imogen Hutchinson this morning, whose hero is the Lord. Pray for Maureen Grant this morning. Pray for Jennifer Clark. Pray for Stephen Curry. And I pray for Claudette, Sister Miller Andel, and her family. Maureen Grant this morning. Pray for all of them. Norma Reed, Sister Janet Chambers. You know their struggles. You know their fight. You know their fight. And Father, because you know their fight, and they have to struggle in this great conflict, in this great controversy, in this struggle for, in this struggle over the arch enemy, because the arch enemy is like a roaring lion. He walks about your people seeking to devour them. I pray for every one of them this morning, oh God, that they may be victorious over the darts of the devil, that you may clad them with the shield of protection. So when the devil shoots his darts against your people, they will be shielded and protected. So I pray this morning for Sister Maria Ramos. You know her struggles. You know her better than she would ever know herself. I'm so thankful for this wonderful woman of God. Everton Slater, bless him and his wonderful wife. His family, bless all of them. Petal Campbell, I pray this morning for Frederica Clark, and you know her issues. Shamin Bihari, I pray for this morning for Sister Griselda Dawson, and you know her big plan. Her big plan, I pray for her and her family. Pray for them this morning. I pray this morning again for Sandra, Sister Sandra Jordan, who is asking for prayer for her cousin Bernard and a brother in Christ who will be undergoing open heart surgery. Open heart surgery this morning. And I pray, oh God, that you may be the physician in the room. You may be the physician with the blade. And I pray, oh God, that you may take your rightful place this morning. And you do what you know best, what you do best, because you are our creator. You are his creator, the one who will be experiencing, oh Father, the knife this morning or today. I pray that everything will be successful. I pray for Dale Charles this morning, Magdalene Lewis. Pray for all of them, Beverly Kelly, and the rest of your children this morning. I want to thank you for them, Tiny Williams. Thank you for Julie, Francis, every one of them this morning. I pray. And those whose name I did not call, bless them, favor, grace. Karen, Avril, pray. I pray. Prisca, Jerome, Stella Ray, I pray for them. You know who they are. Thank you. Give us a successful day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. What a God. What a God we serve. Join us again on Wednesday. Oh, yes, for a continuation as we go deeper into this theme. Yes, we're going to go deeper into the theme in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you again for joining us. Remember, my friends, the gate is still ajar. Those of you who have forgotten it, it is your hero who stands at the gate. The villain, my friends, has no role in whether the gate is open or closed. You can enter through this gate even now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
There is a gate that stands ajar. Thank you. number 368 from the old hymnal. We are bound for the land. Are you bound for the land?
We are bound for the land of the pure.
Amen.
morning, good morning, good morning.
Welcome.
I believe it's a morning song. We can sing this in the afternoon also. But we are going to sing number 34 this morning with the song of joy and gladness. I hope those of you who have not yet awakened, this song may ring in your ears and may get you out of bed. Amen. And those of you who are awakened, you can be revitalized and energized with the song of joy and gladness. Sing along with us. With the song of joy and gladness, lead a bring your noblest list. Banish every thought of sadness, pour in forth highest prayers. Sing to him whose care has brought us once again. Wake the song, wake the song, wake the song of joy and gladness. Wake the song of jubilee. Thanks to thee, O Holy Father, for the mercy of the year. May each heart as yet we gather swell with gratitude sincere. Thanks to thee, O loving Savior, for redemption through thy blood. Breathe upon us, Holy Spirit. Sweetly draw us near to God. Wake the song, wake the song of joy and gladness. Wake the song of jubilee. Song, especially that God saw fit to keep the breath in our nostrils for one more day. We ought to wake the song. We ought to praise Him. We ought to glorify Him. We ought to worship Him. Good morning to you. Amen. Thank you.
Sing the good
Wonderful. Wonderful. That should set you on your way this morning as you prepare for work, as you prepare for school, as you get the children ready, as you are already on the train, on the bus, wherever you may be. My friends, that should give you some hope. I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise. And if God made the mountain rise, He can fix issues in your life this morning. In Jesus' name. Amen. This morning, it's one of our favorites. Matter of fact, it's our favorite because it's your favorite. I would say it's impact favorite. Number 75, the wonder of it all. You know, I'm such a sinner. Yes, yes, yes. I'm a sinner. All have sinned and come short. Like Paul, he says he was a chief of sinners. And it's a wonder that he loves me, a sinner like me. The things that I've done, and he has forgiven me. He has cleansed me from my unrighteousness. There is the wonder of sunset at evening. Let's sing the song. Join us.
There's a wonder of sunset at evening, a wondrous sunrise I see. By the wonder of wonders that thrills my soul is the wonder that God loves me. To think that God loves me. Oh, the wonder of it all, the wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me. There's a sky, the stars, the sun, but the wonder of wonders that thrills my soul is a wonder that's only begun. Oh, the wonder of it all, the wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me. Oh, the wonder of it all, the wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me. Oh, the wonder of it all, the wonder of it all, just to think that God loves me. Just to think that God loves me.
It's a favorite. Brings tears to your eyes. Just to think that Jesus can love a sinner, a liar, a cheat, an alcoholic, a prostitute, a terrible tempered person with bad attitude like me, and he forgives me. He says if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive you all your sins and to cleanse you, cleanse us, cleanse me from all my unrighteousness. What a wonderful God we serve. What a loving God. Amen.
Thank you.
I've chosen to serve him this morning. How about you?
joyful change in my life has been wrought since Jesus came into my heart.
I have light
in my soul, for each long I have sought since Jesus came into my heart. Since Jesus came into my heart. Since Jesus came into my heart. Oh, my soul, like a sibilous roar. Since Jesus came into my heart, I have ceased from my wandering and going astray. Since Jesus came into my heart, and my sins, which were many, are all washed away. Since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, floods of joy on my soul like a sibilous roar. Since Jesus came into my heart, I'm possessed of a hope that is steadfast and sure. Since Jesus came into my heart, and no dark clouds have filled my pathway obscure. Since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into this heart of mine, floods of joy on my soul like a sibilous roar. Since Jesus came into my heart, there's a light in the valley of death now for me. Since Jesus came into my heart, and the lights of the city beyond I can see. Since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into this heart of mine, floods of joy on my soul like a sibilous roar. Since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, floods of joy on my soul like a sibilous roar. Since Jesus came into my heart. Isn't it wonderful to know that since Jesus came into your heart, you are no longer the same person. Amen. Well, another favorite of ours, Love Lifted Me. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore. Yes, love lifted me, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. Far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From the waters lifted me, now safe. Love lifted me, even me, love. even me. Love lifted me, even me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. All my heart to him I gave, ever to him I'll cling. In his blessed presence live, ever his praises sing. Love so mighty and so true, faith
in my soul and
songs, faithful loving service to him. Souls in danger, look above, Jesus completely saves. He will lift you by his love out of the angry waves. He's the master of the sea, he loves his will obey. He, your Savior, wants to be saved today. Love lifted me, even me. Love lifted me, even me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Hallelujah, love lifted me, even me. Love lifted me, even me, when nothing else could help. Love lifted me.
It is indeed love that lifted us out of bed this morning. It will be love that will see us through the day today. It will be love that brings us back home at the end of the day. It is love, my friends, that will cause Jesus to return in the clouds of heaven to take us home to glory. It's love. It's all about love. Amen. Isn't that true? In Jesus' name, amen.
Father's will, he shines in us. my father's word. Oh, let me never forget that though the wrong seems all so strong, God is the room I am. This is my father's world. Why should my heart be sad? The Lord is King, let the heavens ring. God reigns, let the earth be glad.
I've lost some good friends along life's way. Some loved ones departed, they went their way. But thank God I didn't lose everything.
I lost faith in people who said they cared. In the time of my crisis, they were never there. But in my disappointment, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing never changed.
See, I never lost my hope.
My You may have the joy bells ringing in your heart, and a peace that from you never will depart. Walk the straight and narrow way, live for Jesus every day. He will keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Ringing in your heart, you may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior really below, with you everywhere you go. He will keep the joy bells ringing in your heart.
Ooh. Let your life speak when low, Jesus every day.
On his right to every service you can pay, sinners you can help to win. If your life is pure and clean, and you keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Joy bells ringing in your heart, you may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior below, with you everywhere you go, and you keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Joy bells ringing in your heart, you may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior below, with you everywhere you go, and you keep the joy bells.
I'm not afraid to die.
You may have the joy bells ringing in your heart, and a peace that from you never will depart. Walk the straight and narrow way, live for Jesus every day. He will keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Ringing in your heart, you may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior right below, with you everywhere you go. He will keep the joy bells ringing in your heart.
Ooh. Let your life speak well, Lord Jesus.
Right to every service you can pay, sinners you can help to win. If your life is pure and clean, and you keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Joy bells ringing in your heart. You may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior right below, with you everywhere you go, and you keep the joy bells ringing in your heart. Joy bells ringing in your heart. You may have the joy bells ringing in your heart. Thank the Savior right below, with you everywhere you go, and you keep the joy bells.
Thank you. my faith will stand, and I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Abounds in deepest waters, your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never failed and you won't start now. And I call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Oh, presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me, and take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger presence of my Savior. I will call upon your name. call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. Rise, my soul rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, oh. Your grace abounds in deep waters, your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never failed and you won't start now. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Oh, take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith would be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. I will call upon your name, keep my eyes above the waves. My soul rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine.
two men, against one God. 10-year-old Niang got up to go to school while it was still dark outside. She was worried. School worried her every day. Her family had moved as refugees to the United States from Myanmar only a year earlier, and school was hard in the state of Georgia. She didn't speak English very well. She didn't have many friends. And she had to walk to school in the dark. Father could not go with her, because he worked at night. Mother had to stay at home with baby sister. Niang prayed before leaving the house. "Dear God, please help me survive another day of school," she said. "Help me not to get in trouble with a teacher. Keep me safe as I walk to school. Amen." Niang swung her heavy black backpack over her shoulders and stepped out into the dark street. If she took the shortcut, she could reach school in only 10 minutes. She had to walk past a few apartment buildings and through the woods to get to the school. Maybe she would meet some children along the way to keep her company. No other children were in sight as Niang walked through the woods. The air was quiet. The trees looked like dark shadows. Suddenly, two big men loomed in front of her. One of them was holding what appeared to be a white cloth bag. It was limp and empty. He held it out. "Hey, could you hold this for us?" he asked. Niang thought it was a strange question. She stopped and took a few steps back. The men took a few steps forward. Niang anxiously looked around, hoping that other children might be taking the shortcut to school. She didn't see anyone. She looked back at the men. There were two of them and only one of her. They were tall and big, and she was short and small. Would she hold the white bag? "No," Niang exclaimed, shaking her head. Turning around, she ran as fast as she could. The men were surprised. "Oh no," one man said. "Don't run." But Niang wasn't going to stop. She was scared. She had heard stories about children being kidnapped. She knew that the men could easily catch her. "Lord, please help me," she prayed. "Please protect me." She wondered whether they might grab her at any moment. She wanted everything to be right with God. "If I did anything wrong, please forgive me," she prayed. She listened for sounds that the men were pursuing her. Not hearing anything, she stopped for a moment. Her heart was pounding. Then she heard the welcome chatter of children taking the shortcut to school. Relief washed over Niang. She could walk with the other children and be safe. She followed the three younger children toward school. When they reached the spot where the two men had stood, the men were nowhere to be seen. They were gone. Niang heaved a sigh of relief. "Dear God, thank you for protecting me," she prayed. Two big men had been overcome by an even bigger God. 10 years ago, a 13th Sabbath offering helped refugee children like Niang to transfer from public schools to Seventh-day Adventist church schools. Part of this quarter's 13th Sabbath offering will again help refugee children obtain an Adventist education. Thank you for planning a generous offering